Alright. Amnesia, The Dark Descent, Part 8. I needed to take a little bit of a break to recuperate from that horrifying Part 7. But now, I think I'm ready to do Part 8. Seems as though I have to find all the parts to a drill in order to do something. Screaming children, how pleasant. Drill parts, that's good. Now perhaps I can leave this godforsaken storage room. I've gone everywhere in here. It's time to leave and never return. Guest room or study? Guest room sounds a bit more pleasant. We'll go there. Maybe it has a drawing of a cat in it. Cats are happy. Maybe they wanted something happy.
2nd of July, 1839. I received a letter today from the Algerian governor's office disclosing the fate of Herbert's expedition. About a week after my departure, Abdullah, one of the men traveling with us, returned from the desert. He was badly injured, as if maimed by a lion.
Or a grunt.
The man rambled deliriously about the expedition being attacked by something horrible.
Yeah, it's a grunt.
The French quickly dispatched a search party to look for the expedition. After searching for days, they found the camp abandoned without any trace of Herbert or his men. Tomorrow, I'll retrieve the things they recovered from Herbert's tent at the customs house. I don't know what to make of it, but I'm worried for him. Of July, 1839. Today I picked up Herbert's things at the customs house. I dug through the trove of documents he had carried and found a log detailing the expedition. The nature of this text ranged from quick notes to colorful accounts of transpired events. I skimmed the pages, trying to figure out what might have happened. May 17th, the day I was trapped inside the orb chamber, Herbert dryly states, "Recovered Daniel after 1 hour of entrapment." This confused me greatly. I was suffocating within minutes. How could I have lasted an hour? I continued reading the peculiar text. Herbert states his facts without judgment or passion, but suddenly I could read frustration into his text. He pushed his men to investigate the underground tomb, an effort which seems to have strained the minds of his men. Madness spread through the ranks, and Herbert had to take some extreme measures to continue. He finally visits the chamber himself, where he retrieves the orb to the surface. His account confuses me greatly. If he has the orb, what are those pieces in my drawing room?
Daniel.
What?
Still having nightmares, I see.
Yes. I can't shake them. They come every night.
We'll put a stop to them. You'll see.
It was worth a try, I guess. There's got to be something in here to open that door. Maybe there's something in this study. Oh, what's that? What? Wait. That's not an unsettling event. I don't know what is. Well, this is pleasant. I found a dog's head. Sadistic bastard, Alexander. Oh my. Oh dear. Well, he all of a sudden doesn't look too happy. And really, who keeps a bunch of skulls in a cupboard? Alexander, you're one messed up little faggot. Well, before jumping out the window to my inevitable doom, I'm gonna end part 8 here.